Hello and welcome back to MichMusic Now. We are in Moscow, Russia, and you may recognize the iconic building behind us. This is the Bolshoi Theater, the famous ballet venue of Moscow. And we're here for the Spring Festival, the a cappella Moscow Spring Festival, of which there are 170 vocal groups performing all around the city in 40 different venues. It is absolutely amazing. And I'm with my longtime friend and my dear friend, Mr. Matthias Becker from the Frankfurt area in Germany.
Hello, Michele. Hello, everybody.
I want to tell you just 1 minute of biographical information about Matthias, because if you don't spend a lot of time in Europe, you might not know him. Many years ago, when vocal jazz was starting in the United States, simultaneously, literally around the same time, Matthias was building vocal jazz in Europe. He wrote a book, I think it was 30 years ago, yeah?
It was in 89, in fact, when we met first time.
99.
Close to 30 years.
That is very close to 30 years. And So he knew Claire Fisher, he knew Gene Perling, he still knows New York Voices, real group.
Michele Weir, not to forget.
Michele Weir at the top of the list, of course.
Of course.
And so he is someone that is out coaching groups all over Europe and Russia too, by the way. Although you're not coaching, you're judging, but well, whatever.
Who cares?
Yeah, I know. So, anyway, that is Matthias, and I have a question for you.
Okay, go ahead. I don't know yet. Tell me.
You just one
tell me,
tell question.
Me in advance. Okay.
No, it's a secret. I'm sorry. I cannot. But I can tell you now, because
yes,
it's
please.
Time. My question is, I know there are many, many community groups in Europe, meaning adult groups that get together for fun to do vocal jazz and other types of choral music. And I know you're out, and literally there's hundreds, right, around Germany?
Yeah.
And then all over Europe. And I think this is really cool, because we don't have this in the United States, and I think it would be nice if we did. Would you kindly tell us your experience with this and give us more information about these community groups?
Okay. If you ask me, I could write a book about that.
Or a song.
or a song. Well, it's a development that happened in the last 30 years, I would say. Mm-hmm. It started with just a few choirs singing a cappella stuff or Kirby Shaw arrangements or Anita Kerr, one of the first people who did something in vocal pop and vocal jazz. And now after 30 years, it's amazing what people are doing and what love they developed for vocal jazz.
Mm-hmm.
So at that time, as I said, they were performing Kirby Shaw-ish stuff. Now they sing arrangements of Michele Weir, of Carrie Marsh, of Darman Meter, of Gene Perling.
Mm-hmm.
So it's an artistic development that is amazing, but also in the amount of choirs that are doing this.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe in the early 90s there were 20 choirs maybe in Germany. Mm. Now maybe it's even four digits, not hundreds, but
wow.
Four digits. It's amazing.
Wow. That's a lot.
So people still want to sing, but they don't want to sing in the traditional way, like romantic music, Schubert, Brahms, whatever. They are really interested in vocal jazz and vocal pop, which is amazing, and it makes me happy.
Mm-hmm.
To see that people start to love that kind of music, because
mm-hmm.
it's really art, as I learned from Phil Madsen. No, I know. And it's a fantastic development.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm around to support these groups to get even better and to develop and to get to know new music.
Yeah.
So that's the fact, at least in Germany.
Mm-hmm.
There are other countries in Europe that are not that strong, like
mm-hmm.
Germany, for example, Italy. They don't have a strong tradition, strong choir tradition besides opera singing.
Mm-hmm.
Germany is really strong. Denmark is really strong, and mm-hmm. that's because of Jens Johansen and Vocal Line. They have a huge influence
mm-hmm.
on the choral scene. and of course Sweden, mm-hmm. because of the Real Group, Finland because of Rajaton. So there are always some patterns, some groups or some people who make things strong. You know, like in the classical choir music, Erik Eriksson was in Sweden. Now it's the Real Group for the popular music. It was in the 80s, Manhattan Transfer, in the 90s, New York Voices, Take Six. People heard that music and said, wow, I want to do that, even though it's very hard to do, as we know. But they tried. And so it's a very, very exciting development that we can hear. And I'm very excited to be next week at the German Choir Competition that happens every 4 years. And the arrangements they will sing are really of the highest quality you can imagine. That was not possible 20 years ago. Choirs couldn't sing that. Now they can. So that's fantastic.
Yes. Matthias, it's so fascinating what you're doing. And I just would like to be one of the many people that says thank you to you for all of your contributions in this field of choral music, and especially in vocal jazz, because I think without you, honestly, there might not be almost no vocal jazz in Europe, or it would have come much later and probably be at a lower level. You're making giant contributions.
Could be. Thank you very much, Michele. Yeah. My pleasure.
Okay. Thanks, everybody. See you next time. Bye.
Bye.